Dear Worship Leader Series.
Hello everyone and happy Easter. I am Oluwakemi Uguakeze. Welcome to today's episode on Dear Worship Leader Series. Let us see how we can make this Easter remarkable by considering Easter and alignment. Reading from the book of Luke chapter 22 from 42 to 43, NKJV, saying, Father, if it is your will, take this cup away from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but yours be done. Then an angel appeared to him from heaven, strengthening him. What is an alignment? Alignment is an arrangement in a correct and appropriate position. Positioning could either be wrong and it could be right. Positioning deals with your posture and your location, that is where you are. A wrong positioning is already a misalignment. So what is divine alignment? It is an arrangement in correct and appropriate position with God. That is in union with God and in conformity to God. Submitting to God's way, submitting to God's thought, and submitting to God's wisdom. Reading from the book of Colossians chapter 2 and verse 6, the Amplified Version. As you have therefore received Christ, even Jesus the Lord, so walk, regulate your lives, and conduct yourselves in union with and conformity to Him. Alignment is not cheap. Let's see Jesus in alignment with the will of the Father as our perfect example. So now we're going to look at the cost for alignment, as we mentioned that it is not cheap. Number one, brokenness. This makes one to see the need for a particular assignment and going for it at all cost. That is, you are completely sold out. Charles Stanley says, brokenness is God's requirement for maximum usefulness. To be useful to God, we need to be broken. Number two is submission, or surrender to Father's will. We can see from the account of Jesus, nevertheless, not my will, but yours be done. And according to Andrew Murray, it says, God is ready to assume full responsibility for the life wholly yielded to Him. That's amazing. The third prize is the cost of discipline, that is carrying your own cross. You are all by yourself, not with a friend, not with a group of people, but you and God, denying your own interest to follow the footsteps of Jesus Christ. And the fourth one is crucifixion, death to self, but alive in Christ. Colossians chapter 6, 2 verse 6. You can take time to read that. Anyone alive in himself or herself cannot do the will of the Father. If you are alive in yourself, you will war against the will of the Father. Galatians 2:20 says, I have been crucified with Christ. Reading Romans chapter 8, 7 to 8, the Passion Translation. In fact, the mindset focused on the flesh fights God's plan and refuses to submit to His direction because it cannot. For no matter how hard they try, God finds no pleasure with those who are controlled by the flesh. Wow. This is the season for us to ensure we are in alignment with the will of the Father, just as Jesus did while on earth. Without alignment, God cannot pour into us. Just imagine pouring or transferring something. I want to transfer something from this cup to this cup. If it's not in alignment, if it's not well coordinated, then it's going to be a waste. You can imagine they are not in alignment, then there's going to be a waste. God does not waste resources. There is this quote by Nancy Lane Demos. It said, brokenness is the shattering of my self-will, the absolute surrender of my will to the will of God. It is saying, yes, Lord, no resistance, no stubbornness, simply submitting myself to His direction and will in my life. Let this Easter be your season of intentional alignment. And if there's been any misalignment, let this be the season for realignment. Happy Easter. Stay planted, remain connected, remain rooted, and God bless you.